This presentation will introduce you to the origins and various types of estuaries. An estuary is a semi-enclosed basin of water in which fresh water mixes with and significantly dilutes coastal ocean water. Normally, the flow of ocean water is restricted as it enters the estuary, either through a narrow inlet or over a shallow sill. Estuaries can be classified in at least two distinct ways, by geological origin and the degree of mixing of seawater and freshwater. For example, movements in the Earth's crust elevate or lower the coastline, changing the amount of seawater that enters an estuary from the ocean. There are four major classes of estuaries that may be identified on the basis of their origin. These are coastal plain estuaries, fjords, bar-built or barrier island estuaries, and tectonic estuaries. Coastal plain estuaries were formed at the end of the last ice age, when rising seawater flooded the existing river valleys. The Chesapeake Bay is an example of this type of estuary. Fjords are U-shaped valleys with steep walls formed by glaciers that shape the landscape over time. Usually, the glacial deposit left behind pushed advancing glaciers, creating a shallow sill near the entrance to the ocean. The opening toward the sea is called the mouth of the fjord and is often shallow. The fjord's inner part is called the sea bottom. Fjords are common along Norwegian and Canadian coasts and are often surrounded by dramatic mountain scenery. Bar-built or barrier island estuaries are generally separated from land by a shallow lagoon. They are formed by the creation of sandbars parallel with the shore, usually adjacent to slow-flowing rivers that seep fresh water into the coastal waters. Wave action plays a pivotal role in the creation of these sandbars, but their existence also may be caused by some chemical interactions between the salt water and the fresh water. The Outer Banks of North Carolina are an example of this type of estuary. Deltas form at the mouth of large rivers when sediments and silt accumulate rather than being washed away by currents or ocean waves. Over time, a complex set of channels, sand barriers, and marshes form at the mouth of the river. As sediments continue to accumulate, the course of the river may even be changed. Tectonic estuaries are caused by earthquakes, where folding or faulting may create bays with narrow inlets to the sea. San Francisco Bay is an example of this type of estuary. Just as every estuary is different in size and location, the degree in which saltwater and freshwater mix or circulate is also different. This mixture has a huge impact on what organisms can live in the estuary and on how toxic substances are retained or flushed out. How an estuary circulates depends on its size and shape, the amount of freshwater entering into it, the range of tidal action, and on human modifications. Based on their natural characteristics, estuaries can be divided into four main types. Keep in mind that an estuary can be different types at different locations. For example, the ocean end versus the river end, and at different seasons. For example, the rainy season versus the dry season. Because salt water is more dense than fresh water, estuaries tend to contain fresher water at their surface and saltier water at their bottoms. The salt wedge estuary forms where a large river inputs lots of fresh water in an area where the tidal range is low or moderate. The exiting fresh water holds back a wedge of intruding seawater. Because fresh water is less dense than salt water, the river water remains near the top and flows seaward. The seawater wedge moves seaward during falling tides or times of strong river flow. It moves landward during rising tides. Mixing occurs at the boundary between the two water masses and can be especially concentrated at the bay's bottom, where fresh water and salt water meet. This type has a strong salinity gradient from surface to bottom and is found in the mouths of major rivers such as the Mississippi or where rivers enter other estuaries, such as the mouth of the Sacramento into the San Francisco Bay. Well-mixed estuaries, where rivers input smaller amounts of fresh water and the tidal range is moderate to high. Whereas the salt wedge type, there is a strong salinity gradient from surface to bottom. In the well-mixed type, salinity is more constant from surface to bottom. As in other types of estuaries, there is a seaward salinity gradient from fresher water landward to saltier water seaward. Well-mixed conditions tend to occur in shallow estuaries, such as the mouth of the Columbia River, where tidal currents can thoroughly mix river and seawater. This type of estuary is transitional between salt wedge and well mix types and occurs in deeper estuaries with moderately strong tidal currents and greater amounts of river inflow. Mixing is driven both by tidal turbines and river flow. Both the main body of the San Francisco Bay and Puget Sound are examples of partially mixed estuaries. Reverse estuaries are found along arid coasts where rivers cease to flow and the evaporation of seawater cause water to flow from the ocean into the estuary. Reverse estuaries, sometimes called lagoons, are common along the Pacific coast of Mexico's Baja Peninsula and along the U.S. Gulf Coast. Because of high evaporation, salinity values in the estuary often exceed that of the open ocean. No matter the origin or type of estuary, we need to remember that estuaries are national treasures, vital ecological and community resources, whose health affects our health and the vibrancy of our communities and economies.